Greetings, I am Solidus-Skully, and welcome back to the final part of Resident Evil 2. Well, I mean, I say the final part of the Resident Evil 2 commentary, but I mean mostly for this scenario. We will be getting back to this quite, well, within a reasonable amount of time, I hope. Mostly because of plant stuff, which I'll probably talk about when we get to the end credits. But anyway, yes, we're finishing off this game tonight, goddammit, and there is a lot of cutscenes with, few places to talk, really, I suppose. So I might as well get all my tangents out of the way now. Well, what few tangents I really have left, mind you. It's mostly a case of gathering the ammo disc, because we've got to have more disc! And just using up whatever ammo we have left for the Magnum. This is also the point of the game where we come to meet some new zombies, which I was alluding to last part, and, well, it is quite random. Also some very weird, specific zombies here, which are wearing, like, lab technician gear. More so than the different lab coats, they are actually different models, which is a bit surprising and also something cool that I do appreciate about Resident Evil 2, in the sense that they had a bunch of different zombie models compared to the first game, where it was really just the same one or two zombies in, like, lab or casual gear. I don't know. It's just something nice, because you can tell the difference between civilian zombies, police officers, then, you know, zombies that work for Umbrella. It's a nice little attention to detail. I mean, they could have just really gone for the cheap route and just had the lab coat zombies, but, you know, appreciate the subtle differences.
You murdered my husband! I know what you're looking for! You came for the T-Virus, didn't you? From me. This is my husband's legacy. Now, where's that spy you were working with earlier? You know who I'm talking about.
What?
You really don't know anything, do you? You're so gullible. She's one of the operatives sent here by the agency. The only reason why she came here is to obtain the G-Virus.
That's a lie!
No, it's the truth. I discovered this when I did a background check on her. She specifically got close to John and became his girlfriend to get information about Umbrella.
That can't be. I know her. Ada wouldn't do something like that.
If you don't want to believe it, I don't really care. You're about to die anyway. What happened?
Make just a quick comment here. This is something that really bothers me in the Claire A scenario.
The self-destruct sequence has been activated. Repeat, the self-destruct sequence has been activated. This sequence may not be aborted. All employees proceed to the emergency car at the bottom platform.
It wouldn't be a Resident Evil game if we didn't have to run for our lives. And bye, Annette Birkin, you're not actually dead just yet. Anyway, well, actually we don't. Actually, we'll be seeing Annette a little bit later. In fact, by that, I mean right now. I apologize for rambling, but now it is time for some interesting revelations!
Leon. I've been waiting for you, Leon.
What are you doing?
You know what this is about. So just hand over the G-Virus.
I don't believe this. Annette was right. About everything.
That's why I told you to leave without me, but you wouldn't listen. Now hand it over. Don't make me shoot you.
You can't do that. Ada! I've got you! Don't give up!
It's over. Just let me go.
Shut up! promise you that we would escape. You just have to help me out here.
I really want to escape with you, Leon. Escape from everything. Goodbye.
Ada!
One to fill your dark soul with light is exactly what I think about that scene right there. Or at the very least in terms of music, because it, I mean, I know same composer, Masami Ueda, but I kind of make the comparison, and again, all jokes aside, that is, I think, a very touching scene. It's made infinitely more cheesier with the Leon B scenario, but again, in the Leon A scenario, that, again, despite being PS1 and Resident Evil, again, that's touching, man. I like it. I mean, then again, Ada's flip-flopping personality is an issue. Well, no, a bit of an ongoing one, actually, considering the rest of the series, but, you know, the scene still works. And the fact that Annette Birkin is still up and walking around, and believe it or not, she is still not dead after that. Anyway, we have no time to talk about love plots and science stuff, because now we have some red-hot NAKIE zombie action. These were the zombies that I was talking about before. They're buck-ass naked, and in the Resident Evil 2 remake, you know, photorealistic graphics, hyper-detailed penis. Oh yeah. Hyper-detailed asses too. Jesus, that's getting a bit close for comfort. Again, all jokes aside though. Yeah. Oh god! That was a close one. Almost had his ass in full view of the camera. Anyway. We now have a Resident Evil escape sequence, which is obvious, but, you know, staple of the series. Well, the classic games, anyway. Not really much use for herbs, though, since we're pretty much just going to be making a straight-up run for it. Well, actually we do, because I just remember there is one last boss that we have to face. I was thinking about another certain scenario, but we won't get into that until much later. And now we can escape through that, cartridge that, well, the door that looks like a cartridge. I know it's meant to be a blast door, but I don't know. I think of an ancient video game console. But yeah, Ada was a spy, Leon's love has been shattered forever, and it's from this day forward that he learns to, I don't know, be cooler, smoother with the ladies, at least by Resident Evil 4 standards anyway. Whenever do you see that transitional game, though? Like, I mean, it kind of goes from, like, dorky rookie cop to badass secret agent in the span of a game. I mean, he's only ever mentioned in Code Veronica since, I don't know. We really did need, like, tie-in game which shows the destruction of Umbrella. Although I suppose Resident Evil Stock Exchange probably wouldn't do very well, but then again, still a better spin-off idea than... What was the shitty spin-off nobody liked? Was it... I don't think it was Operation Raccoon City? I don't remember. It was the one where you could actually, like, get infected and turn into a zombie, I think. I might be getting my wires crossed with that one. But anyway, say goodbye to this lovely facility and all of its ambient music, which I neglected to comment on earlier, unfortunately, due to my scrambled brain, but... Again, I really do like the ambient music pieces of the Umbrella Labs. It is... Honestly, some of my favorite compositions by Masami Ueda. Why am I having so much trouble thinking of that? In any case, we are now at the final arena. 5 minutes until detonation. And now we have a time limit. Well, we already had a time limit before, but now it's for realsies. And now we head off to the elevator, which is misspelled, but then again, Japan, so I can let it slide. Or not, I suppose. Really depends upon how anal you are about grammar. What is this? Ah, seems Mr. Birkin took the quick way down. Anyway, we are now at the final boss, William Birkin in form 4 or 5, against Leon Kennedy with a magnum. And now he transforms into... What I'm pretty sure is... I'm trying to compare it to an enemy in Devil May Cry, because I think... Because of the fact that the same team that worked on this game worked on that game, I'm trying to remember what sort of enemy this was based on. I think it might have been a form of the Nightmare Beta, actually. That was the name of the weapon, I forgot. I think it was just called Nightmare? Whatever. Anyway, Leon against the Lion King, the G-Virus Lion, whatever. Even though William Birkin jumps around, and he will hurt if he catches you, so be on your guard. Yeah, you kind of have to be a little bit more active and take more pot shots. And then again, you can be a brave son of a bitch and just use your magnum, because at this stage you might as well. But yeah, because of the fact that he is a lot more agile, he has a lot more chances to... Ugh, good lord. Yeah, he has a lot more chances to catch you, so all I can say... Run away... It's pretty much the same sort of strategy I'd recommend for the Tyrant boss fight in Resident Evil 1. Just run away, take pot shots, and try and... Don't let him hit you. Again, simple strategy, but in this case, it really does mean the difference between life and death. I can really just recommend taking a lot of healing items with you if you aren't particularly adept at this sort of thing. Which, you know, for some newer players of the newer generation, I can see why, but honestly, when you by this stage in the game, you should have mastered tank controls. Especially considering that I think Resident Evil 2 is one of the more user-friendly games in the series. But anyway, Billy Birkin is dead, and now we can leave his decomposing corpse behind and escape from the Raccoon City, named after its founding father, Sly Cooper. And now we're about to face off against Metal Gear. Or at least I presume we are. No, we're actually at the end of the game right now. Well, the end of Leon's portion anyway, so I'm gonna take a drink of the Pepsi and you can enjoy the last cutscene. That, my friends, was the Resident Evil 2 commentary. For the A scenario, again, we've still got plenty to go, and I fucking love the song. It is an absolutely beautiful piano piece that is just... I'm sorry, but I want to stay silent about that and, you know, I gotta commentate over the game. Anyway, I guess we'll get into final thoughts, in regards to the A scenario. Overall, I do think this game does kind of have the same sort of problem that Resident Evil 1 did, where, you know, the first bit of the game, and the one which is meant to engage players the most, does kind of drag in certain respects, but again, it's mostly standard Resident Evil formula. You know, walk around the police station, gather around items, and get yourself ready. While it might be a little bit slow in terms of pacing and discovering what the overall plot is, you know, in terms of having a decent cutscene to gameplay ratio, I think it does balance out as you go on a bit further, and I think comparatively to Resident Evil 1, in terms of both horror and action, I think the game has a much well, I wouldn't say has a much better balance, but it has a little bit more focus on the specific elements that need to work in its favour. You know, you'll have cutscenes of Lickers trying to attack you, you'll have new enemies introduced naturally, and overall, you know, it makes Resident Evil 2, I think, a very easy game to get into. I know a lot of people would probably say this game's ancient and archaic and it has tank control, so go with a remake, but honestly, I'd still recommend Resident Evil 2 to a gamer of the modern age. I mean, sure, tank controls, you know, everybody has their own taste in terms of control scheme, but ultimately, I would highly recommend you give this a shot. Now, I suppose in terms of story in the A scenario, well, again, I honestly prefer this version of the plot a bit better because it cuts out certain plot elements that in the canon scenario, which is Claire A, that I don't think entirely work and actually create some very gaping, well, I wouldn't say gaping plot holes, but enough to kind of raise an eyebrow. Again, I think Ada and Leon's dialogue in this version is a little bit, you know, more naturally handled, and ultimately, well, I think Leon A works in terms of being a story, so, again, I really enjoyed this. I mean, despite the fact that, well, okay, I'll probably get into that a little bit later, because I really love this ending piano piece. It's just cool like that. The sort of piano piece where you say something inspirational. No matter how you feel about the game, we can all come together in harmony and love Resident Evil 2. You go, you beautiful son of a bitch! Now I suppose I might as well talk about what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to be holding off on Claire B scenario because I want to have the Resident Evil 2 remake under my belt so I can have a little bit more to compare and contrast the games with and ultimately have more to say in the Claire B scenario. And yeah, again, I do apologize if anybody is going to be a little bit saddened by that, but then again, I take it most of my audience doesn't really care about anything that isn't platform-related. Also, I presume that might be me being a little bit presumptuous, but anyway. I had fun with this game, and I got an A ranking because I'm awesome! And yet I still don't have a girlfriend. I'm sad now. So anyway, for my next commentary that you'll be seeing next, I'm going to be doing a little bit of a modified run of a little game called Shadow the Hedgehog. I'm Solidus-Skully, keep it new metal, and I wish you all a good Sunday night. Take care, and I will see you with Shadow the Hedgehog. Bye-bye.